books, guidance, growth. Welcome to When to Read What podcast, and this is Harshal, your host.
Hey guys, welcome to When to Read What podcast, and today we have got a young and dynamic filmmaker and founder of Avleen Anand Production, Miss Avleen Anand. She is an independent artist and a filmmaker who takes pride in her work, and it shows her in her craft. In her films, she will touch on those issues that people don't like to either talk about or are too hesitant to come out. Apart from it, Avleen is fondly remembered as Monica from her national television show, P.S. I Hate You. And recently, she has come up with her first book, To My Imperfect Parents, Thank You. Hi, Avleen. Welcome to the show.
Hi. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm good.
Yeah, cool. So let us just start off the podcast. And here's my first question. So can you please start off by informing our listeners what To My Imperfect Parents, Thank You is all about?
Yes. So this book is a memoir. It's about my own experiences that I have, you know, been through. And it's like a thankful gesture towards my parents for being imperfect in their own ways. They use their mindful tactics without even knowing that they are using it. So it's from a daughter or from a son or from a parent to their parents for being imperfect.
Wow, that was some amazing introduction about the book. So as I was reading the book, I was amazed by the fact that you were able to write such a complex and sensitive subject in a simplistic way. So I want to know, what is the motivation behind writing To My Imperfect Parents, Thank You?
So Harshal, it took me 2 years to write this book actually. And it started with one of my clients who wanted me to write a book on parenting. And see, I'm a single woman. I have no idea about, being a parent and going through that phase, because obviously I'm a single girl. So she was, she narrated me her stories and her incidents from her life. And she said, you know, Avleen, I want you to write this book, because somewhere she believed in me. But because of some, you know, commercial aspects and, you know, things didn't turn out that way. So I decided to take this book in my hand and, you know, chuck her part, leave her things, but carry her wisdom with me. So I think her wisdom and my experiences as a daughter and recently as a nanny to my niece, it turned out pretty well in the book. So I think that was the inspiration for me, you know, I would say, for this book.
Yeah, I totally agree with you on that part, because I think that combining experience with your wisdom is can give best results. And I can totally see it in your book. So now coming on to the next question. So I think that we are getting away from the actual conversation or communication in our day-to-day life. And that is especially true when it comes to having a conversation with our parents or with whoever we love or someone we are close to. So do you think that kids aren't able to communicate with their parents as effectively as we used to communicate when we were younger?
So I think, Harshal, the entire point depends on parents and their parenting methods. If the parents are friendly and they understand their child very well and they are mindful, they are present in that situation, communication will be easy. It is a practice that one family must follow to communicate with their child, and then only child can learn from you, from your actions, and then you know, they can come to you and they can talk about your things. Like in my family, I find it very easy to talk about many issues with my parents. Like I think almost every issue with my parents, because they have created that comfort zone for me to come and say whatever I want to say, and they will not judge me, for sure.
Wow, that's amazing. I think you are pretty blessed to have parents like that, because
because
considering the all around means situation across the country or across the globe, kids are not that much open to their parents, and they are not means very comfortable sharing their feelings with them.
See, around the globe, I have no idea because I haven't been to that part. But yes, I know few children and few parents. I don't know what happened to the parenting methods nowadays, because it turned out to be more difficult to reach out to your parents even. And I think I still remember one of the interview of Oprah with Aishwarya Rai. And, you know, there is this question Oprah asked Aishwarya Rai Bachchan that is, you know, what do you think about divorces and stuff like that? And are you so much elder and you're still living with your parents? So she said, we are not seeking appointments to meet our parents. In terms of Western culture, they actually go and, you know, seek appointment to meet their parents. But it's not here. The entire parenting method over here is absolutely different. It's based on, you know, more of religious and spiritual awakening, I would say. That matters a lot, because being a parent, you should know what you are doing. And that is what your child will going to reflect in near future.
Yeah, totally. And guys, I have got an announcement to make over here. So I am pleased to inform you that we are giving out some free copies of To My Imperfect Parents. Thank you. And you just need to like this video and subscribe to When to Read What, and also to Avleen's YouTube channel, which you will find the link in the description or in the card I will mention over somewhere over here. And you have to share your thoughts in the comment section down below. So the giveaway is majorly divided into two parts. So in the first part, Avleen is going to choose one best comment who will be getting signed copy of To My Imperfect Parents. Thank you. And for the second part, please stay tuned. So now let us just get back to the show. So in the book, Avleen, you have talked a lot about conscious parenting. So what is conscious parenting and why it is important?
Conscious parenting, actually, it's a term that we use for those parents who are living in the moment and, you know, responding to their child by being mindful. That is what, in simpler terms, it is what we call as, you know, conscious parenting. That if I'm talking to my mother or my father, but their thought is somewhere else, and, you know, they're thinking of something else, and they're, you know, taking out their grudge or complaint or, you know, I don't know, bashing, maybe whatever you can say to me in that moment, I will not learn anything. I'll be like, my parents react to my situation in such a way, then what's the need? Why to talk to them? So conscious parenting, you know, in today's time, it's a very trendy term. Aaj ke time, it's like, ke bahut zyada mindfulness, mindful parenting aage, lekin ye shuru se hai hamare paas. लेकिन हमने इसको कभी यूज नहीं किया. हमारे पेरेंट्स ने जाने अनजाने में इस तरीके की पेरेंटिंग करी दैट नाउ वी आर कंफर्टेबल टू टॉक टू दोज पीपल इजीली. लेकिन आज के टाइम में ना इतना एनवायरमेंटल केओस हो गया है दैट इवन पेरेंट्स को भी हमें ब्लेम नहीं करना चाहिए, क्योंकि उनको उनको बेसिक लाइफस्टाइल मेंटेन करने के लिए भी बहुत हसल करना पड़ रहा है. सो इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट आज के टाइम में कि प्रेजेंट भी रहना है एंड चाइल्ड के लिए अवेलेबल भी रहना है और अपना ख्याल भी खुद रखना है. बट देन वी से यू आर अ पेरेंट एंड यू हैव टू बी, यू नो, यू हैव टू हैंडल एवरी सिंगल थिंग बाय डूइंग व्हाट एवर पॉसिबल थिंग यू कैन डू.
वाओ. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, आई रिमेम्बर दैट यू हैव मेंशन इन योर बुक दैट लेट द चिल्ड्रन ग्रो ऑर्गेनिकली. So,
yes.
In this particular context, what do you mean by grow organically?
See, let the children grow organically means let them feel that emotion, let them be in the moment, and let them, you know, do whatever they want to do, even if they are making mistakes or, you know, crying or laughing or, you know, saying something. You as a parent, be mindful that, you know, it should not go beyond a line. And then try to make your child understand, you know, this is right and this is wrong. But just do not interrupt that organic living. Yeah. You can do that later. Normally, hota na, hamare parents humko ek point ke baad bol dete ki aise nahi karna chahiye tha, aise karna chahiye tha. Agar wo cheez aap kis unko beech mein na tok ke 5-10 minute ke baad samjha loge, I think uska impact zyada acha padega.
Yeah, totally. I agree with you. And apart from that, when children are growing, I think that it is natural for them to have a few tantrums. So can you please share your experience with our listeners, with your nephew and niece, that what did it exactly taught you about the tantrums?
See, tantrums, not only we as a my niece and nephew did, but we as adults even do, because, you know, we go to market and we have seen something good and we wanted to purchase it. So hum bhi apna koi reason bana lete hain. You know, this sari is good. This phone is good. You know, I have to buy an Apple iPhone, you know, it's in trend and I have to click that iPhone selfie. So we as adults do tantrums. Now comes to kids. So kids are like very, you know, वो एकदम एक साफ एक पर्दा है, मतलब उस पर कुछ नहीं है, उनको जो चाहिए वो चाहिए. नाउ माय नीस एंड नेफ्यू, वी वेंट टू मॉल एंड देयर वाज दिस डिस्प्ले मेन्यू ऑफ वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट फ्रेंचाइजी, आई डोंट इवन रिमेम्बर द नेम नाउ, एंड दे हैड दिस शेक्स एंड फ्राइज कमिंग आउट ऑफ देयर एडवर्टाइजमेंट. नाउ माय नीस एंड नेफ्यू, एंड आई थिंक दे वर लाइक 4 or 8 बाय देन, दे वर लाइक मासी, यू नो आई वॉन्ट दिस शेक. I was like, beta, this is too big for you. Itna bada shake kaun peeta hai aur itna fries kaun khayega? They're like, Masi, no, I want this. Masi, I want this. And we took 2 big shakes. And that too, small tummies can't hold it. Aur main un dono ka wait kar rahi thi. I'll order my stuff after they will finish this. So I was like, ye to nahi kar payenge. So this is the kind of, you know, the advertisement is in such a way ki wo allure karne ke liye banaya gaya hai bachcho ko. उनकी भी गलती नहीं, बिकॉज दे हैव टू सेल देयर प्रोडक्ट्स, और बच्चों की भी गलती नहीं, बिकॉज दे आर वेरी मच, यू नो, अनफिल्टर्ड स्पीशीज ऑन दिस अर्थ. तो इसलिए कहते हैं ना, बच्चे भगवान का रूप. तो ये तो टैंट्रम चलेंगे ही चलेंगे, एंड यू जस्ट कांट इग्नोर इट.
या कूल. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ डिबेट इन एवरी फैमिली, आई थिंक दैट हु इज द बेस्ट पेरेंट. सो प्लीज कैन यू शेयर योर थॉट्स अबाउट इट?
या, हु इज द बेस्ट पेरेंट? हु इज योर बेस्ट पेरेंट? Mama or Papa?
I don't know. To be very frank, actually, when I am at home, I am Mama's boy, and when I am when I am not at home, means even I am what should I say? Actually, I am not able to get that only.
See, that is the point, because you know, at this stage, we know the importance of mother and father respectively, but as a kid. As a child who is unfiltered, who doesn't know anything, you know, we have this inclination, because mother has, you know, utmost pure bond since birth wala scene ho jata hai. Lekin, I would say, if it comes to me, I would say my father has given me so much, you know, practical knowledge to live in this world, which is actually chaotic. Or mama give me that, you know, to empathize with the world. So, दोनों को मिक्स करके द अवलीन इज आउट इन फ्रंट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. तो ये चीज एक अमेलगमेशन शुड बी वेरी बैलेंस्ड. यू नो, अ फादर शुड नो वॉट ही इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग इन हिज और हर चाइल्ड इन हिज चाइल्ड बर्थ, और वॉट मम्मा इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग, वो तो उनको एक, आई डोंट नो, देर इज दिस इनेट होता है ना, अंदर से ही कुछ आता है, और कि I am a mother and I have to be this soft and that soft and I have to be this much, you know, controlling or that much controlling. So unke ek andar se aata hai, but father has a hell lot of responsibility jo hum kabhi kabhi ignore kar dete hain, and we should not ignore our fathers actually. Main to yahi bolungi.
Yeah, totally. And actually, you have mentioned earlier also, means in this podcast only, that kids are the mirror image of their parents. So
absolutely.
Can you just suggest, means what parents can do so that their child grows up to, means grows to become much more, means good, kind human being?
The most important thing in today's time is to listen to your child and observe his or her needs. That whatever he or she is doing, is it right for his, you know, the growth? The development, is it required? And you know, just as a parent, you should discuss, both husband and wife should discuss what is good and what is not good, but keeping in mind that your child is still learning. He's fragile, he's innocent, he or she is innocent, and you know, one should not impose your thoughts onto them. Parents should not impose देयर थॉट्स ऑनटू देयर चाइल्ड, क्योंकि फिर आई थिंक वो कहीं ना कहीं एक ब्रेक आ जाता है उस लाइन में, उस बॉन्ड में. जितना आप अपने बच्चे को सुनोगे, ऑब्जर्व करोगे, चीजें उतनी आपके लिए भी आसान होंगी. एंड आपके चाइल्ड को भी पता चलेगा, ओके नाउ आई कैन टॉक टू माय पेरेंट्स अबाउट एनीथिंग. सो ये बैलेंस बना के चलोगे तो थिंग्स विल बी ऑल राइट. आई डोंट नो, आई एम अ सिंगल वुमन, आई कैन से सो मच अबाउट पेरेंटिंग.
Well, it is absolutely cool that you have got a lot of wisdom earlier in the life itself, and I think it will be definitely helpful for you in the near future once you
absolutely.
Yeah. So apart from it, can you tell our viewers or listeners what they can expect from this book? As in, what kind of solution to parenting they can expect while they are reading this book?
So first thing first is that this book is about being thankful towards your parents, towards your grandparents, even towards your siblings, and also towards yourself, that you have, you know, faced so much, you know, and now you are in front of the world. And secondly, being, you know, see, I cannot say too much, but once you will read this book, you will realize that हमारे पेरेंट्स ने जो भी किया है वो हमारे अच्छे के लिए ही किया है, एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी आर हियर, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट देम. सो मुझे लगता है कि वी शुड नॉट जज एनीवन इमीडिएटली, चाहे वो हमारे पेरेंट्स हो, एंड पेरेंट्स शुड नॉट जज देयर चाइल्ड इमीडिएटली. तो जितना भी हो, अगर हम सुन के और बात करके चीजों को सॉल्व करें तो वो शायद हमारे लिए ज्यादा अच्छा होगा, एज कम्पेयर टू यू नो क्विकली जम्पिंग टू कंक्लूजन्स. And also, live in the moment is the most important thing.
Wow, that was some amazing insight about the book. And now coming to my last and my signature question, when to read to my imperfect parents, thank you.
You can read Imperfect Parents, Thank You whenever you want to read this, because, you know, this is a kind of a book that will help you to be more grateful towards life and towards the various aspects of life. Iske liye koi, there is no special time, no special place. Just open the book, read it, and you know, you will think, if you have parents with you, you are blessed. And if you haven't have your parents with you, then I would say, you know, there will this feeling inside you ke ya to humne unko thank you bol diya hota, you know, ya I don't know. You know, there is, this book came out of so much vulnerability. Mere bhi emotions itne zyada involved hai ki kabhi mujhe jab bhi poochte hai ki aap kaise isko describe karte ho, it's very very difficult for me to describe this book, because I lost two people while writing this book, and that was my grandfather and my aunt, my mommy, and the emotion this book carries is altogether different. So I think you can read it whenever you want to read it and feel grateful towards your parents, your family members, your relatives, and whosoever is there for you in your journey.
Hey, wow, that was really amazing. So apart from it, can you please tell our listeners how can they connect with you?
Yes, you can connect with me on Instagram, and it's AvleenAnand9. And also you can email me, it's aaproductions9@gmail.com.
Hey, wow. Thanks, Avleen. I will mention all the links down below. And for the second part of the giveaway, you just need to follow us on our Instagram handle. And you are going to find a giveaway detail in the highlight section. So to know the results, please subscribe to When to Read What and also press the bell icon so that you can get notified as soon as the winner is announced. So thank you so much, Avleen, for your your wonderful wisdom, and you have given us a lot of time over here.
Thank you so much. I had fun.
Yeah, thank you so much, Avleen. So until then, happy reading to my imperfect parents. Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye.